Ghana, up to 30% of mangroves have been lost to degradation and destruction in the last 25 years. This has knock-on effects as mangroves provide vital ecosystem services, supporting livelihoods, fisheries, timber, and fuel wood. They also act as natural barrier, protecting vulnerable communities against erosion and capture carbon from the atmosphere. They are critical for biodiversity, providing breeding grounds for fish populations and homes to many biodiverse fauna.
Here in Akplautoko, processing of fish from both the sea and the river is our main occupation as women, and we depend mainly on the mangrove as our only source of firewood.
I am into the firewood business. When we harvest the mangrove for firewood from a particular place, we replant the field. We are paid for our labor after the firewood is sold. The money we earn from this business is what we use for our upkeep. With this business, I was able to send all my 6 children to school.
If you take the various biodiversity, we have the mangroves, which has 3 species. For the fauna, we have the sea turtle, the West African manatee, and then the West African sitatunga. In addition to that, we are aware that this area is also a site for the migratory birds and then the sea turtle.
There are some animal species that use the mangroves as their habitat, such as monitor lizards and turtles. Our concern now is how to protect these species through the preservation of these mangroves.
The World Bank, of course, is supporting us through a project known as WACA, where we are looking at building resilience along some coastal communities. Therefore, we are going to use mangroves as one of those interventions. PROBLUE is working also with us. They're carrying out a number of assessments, looking at how women depend on mangroves.
This analysis will be scaled up for other local institutions and West African governments. This is part of the World Bank's broader integrated land and seascape management approach, Reef to Reef.
The Forestry Commission supports the PROBLUE and PROBLUE Green agenda. Last year, a total of about 20,000 seedlings were planted during the Greening Ghana commemoration. And throughout last year, a total of about 17 hectares of degraded mangrove habitats have been restored. This is what the Forestry Commission has done.
I am so excited to be part of a team of women employed here. This is a huge encouragement for us, the women. Our job here is to nest the mangrove seedlings in these reused water sachet plastic bags and transplant them to the field when they are ready. This is important because the fish stock in the lagoon will grow bigger in size again.
A first for the World Bank in Africa, a mangrove blue carbon pilot program was recently announced, financed by PROBLUE, IDA, and energy company Ørsted. The funds will go for planting, technical assistance, and maintenance over 20 years of 3,000 hectares of mangroves in Ghana under WACA. The World Bank, with PROBLUE support, is also providing technical assistance with a series of mangrove studies in the area intended to help the government of Ghana strategically plan sustainable use of mangroves in the communities.
We have had some good experience with the program in their support for landscape activities, and currently we're working with the PROBLUE, which has to do with the Keta Songo area, which is going to be rehabilitated and increase the awareness in that area to protect that wetland.
The World Bank, with PROBLUE support, is also working with the government of Ghana on other broader sustainable ocean plans, SOP.
We are excited about it and looking forward to having a very inclusive and comprehensive SOP to bring a lot of traction on ocean-based activities. We see a lot of opportunities that's remained untapped in the ocean, and we want to leverage that for national development to address issues of poverty, inclusion, and to safeguard the environment for current and future generations.